In our last episode, we saw that the army of Usama left Medina with almost 3,000 men. As ordered, the army marched towards Tabuk. The local tribes of the region fought fiercely against the Muslims. Usama swept through northern Arabia, fighting skirmishes, and brought the tribes under control and reached up to Damat al-Zandal. Then, Usama led the army to Mu'tah and fought against a local Christian tribe named Ghassan and defeated them. After 40 days of mission, the army returned to Medina with a considerable amount of wealth collected as taxes and tributes from the local tribes of northern Arabia. The gains from this mission provided Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu with enough resources to fund full-fledged military actions against apostasy. In the meantime, the situation of Muslims deteriorated in Arabia in general. After the defeat in Zulkisah, several apostate clans took revenge on the local Muslims by torturing and killing them. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was constantly receiving these updates, and he swore to avenge the fellow Muslims who fell victim to the infidels. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu started planning his next steps. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu first put his focus on the concentration of the apostate army in Abrak. A few days later, the Muslims marched out of Medina towards Abrak. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu led the army himself. Once they reached Abrak, they found that the apostate army was already in battle formation. So the fighting began immediately. Although the apostates were higher in number, they were low in morale after losing the previous two confrontations against the Muslims. This time as well, there was no exception. After a fierce confrontation, the apostates lost their spirit and started to flee from the battlefield. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu led the Muslim army to another victory. Seeing the swift comeback of the Muslims, many tribes decided to re-accept Islam and agreed to give taxes. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu accepted their offer. After the victory at Abrak, the Muslim army returned to Medina. Here, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu laid out his plan to eradicate apostasy from Arabia once and for all. He realized that it would not be effective if he would send one large army and fight different enemies one after another. That would give the enemies a chance to unify and overpower the Muslims, as the Muslims were lower in number. Rather, his plan depended on sending several shock troops simultaneously to different parts of Arabia, strike the enemy with lightning speed, and win quick victories before the apostates could unite. Keeping that goal in mind, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu divided the entire Muslim army in 11 groups, appointed a leader for each group, and gave them a specific objective to bring the apostasy under control. The commander of each group and their objectives were Khalid ibn al-Walid. He was ordered to fight Tulayha at Buzaka and then Malik ibn Nuwayra at Butah. Ikrima ibn Abi Jahl. He was ordered to garrison near Yamama, but not to get involved with the army of Musaylimah until more reinforcements were sent. Amr ibn al-As. He was ordered to march towards Tabuk and Damat al-Zandal and keep the local tribes in control. Shurahbil bin Hasana. His instruction was to follow Ikrima and await further instructions. Khalid bin Sa'id. His troops were sent to the Syrian frontier to fight certain apostate tribes there. Turaifa bin Haziz. His mission was to subdue the Hawazin and Bani Sulaim in the area east of Medina and Makkah. Al-Ala al-Hadrami. He was ordered to march to Bahrain. Hudhayfa bin Mihsan, his mission was to bring order in Oman. Arfaza bin Harshama, he was ordered to go to Mahra region in South Yemen and fight the apostates there. Muhazir ibn Abi Umayyah, his troops were sent to central Yemen to bring the situation under control. Suwaid bin Mukarran, his order was to fight the apostates in the coastal area north of Yemen. Among the newly appointed commanders, Khalid ibn al-Walid was Abu Bakr's radiallahu anhu, most effective trump card against the enemy. So he gave the strongest portion of the Muslim army under Khalid's command and sent them to fight the most formidable enemies. As soon as the reorganization of the army was done, each commander marched with his troops to their mission. Khalid's first objective was to fight the false prophet Tulaiha, who was gathering his followers at a place called Puzaka to fight the Muslims. He was mainly supported by the tribe of Ghatafan and Tayyar. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu also sent a devout Muslim from Tayyar clan named Adi bin Hatim with Khalid in the hope that he would be able to persuade his clansmen to rejoin the Muslims. And his plan worked. Along the march towards Buzaka, Adi bin Hatim convinced the Tayyar and Jadila tribe to change their religions, revert to Islam, and also acquired around 1500 extra warriors from these tribes to join Khalid's force. With these new troops, Khalid now had around 6,000 men under his command. In mid-September of 632, the two armies came face to face at Buzaka. The battle began with Khalid ordering the entire Muslim front to charge. Initially, the apostates could resist the Muslim attack, but soon the Muslims started gaining grounds. After the fight continued on for several hours, the Muslims were almost at a point of breaking the enemy line. Realizing that the situation was getting out of control, Tulaiha fled the battlefield. The apostate army lost its morale and started to flee. The Muslims chased the apostates down and took many prisoners. Tulaiha fled to the border of Syria and never returned to fight the Muslims again. After the victory of the Muslims against the false prophet Tulaiha, many tribes that previously supported Tulaiha reverted to Islam. Their reversion was accepted. Only the people who tortured and murdered innocent Muslims during the period of apostasy were arrested and were put on trial. With this arrangement, Khalid's first mission objective was accomplished. This victory showed the apostates that the Muslims were no longer in the defensive stance. Rather, they were taking the offensive stance against apostasy. The Ridawa was in full swing.